Cataract surgery in eyes with coloboma is challenging as it poses greater risk of complications due to its associated ocular malformations. The intraoperative complications are doubled while performing phacoemulsification in cataracts with coloboma. There are very few reports on the performance of manual small incision cataract surgery in eyes with congenital coloboma. This video demonstrates the manual small incision cataract surgery in a case of hypermature cataract with coloboma without the use of capsular tension rings. After conjunctival peritomy and adequate cautery, a temporal curvilinear incision is made. The scleral incision is usually made opposite to the coloboma as it would be easy to perform the nucleus prolapse and other intraoperative maneuvers during the surgery. An adequate sized and well-constructed tunnel is crucial to the outcome of the surgery, which could reduce the intraoperative and postoperative complications. A complete and adequate size capsulorhexis is performed under Trifan blue staining and following the triple soft shell technique, where a dispersive viscoelastic device coats and protects the endothelium, followed by a coarser viscoelastic in the center to maintain space and a lake of balanced solution overlying the nucleus in which the capsulorhexis can be performed with ease. After initial puncture with the cystitome, the liquefied cortex is aspirated with the 26-gauge cannula to reduce the intralenticular pressure, thus reducing the chances of capsulorhexis extension. The aspiration of the liquefied cortex can be done multiple times as when needed. The rhexis is then completed with the help of a forceps. Hydrodissection should be done with caution as it can lead to zonal dialysis, especially around the area of coloboma. The nucleus is then prolapsed by the bimanual technique, where a cyclodialysis spatula is used to lift the edge of the nucleus, while the Sinsky hook is used to rotate the nucleus out of the capsular bag into the anterior chamber. Here, only one end of the nucleus is prolapsed, allowing space for the insertion of the irrigating vectors to go beneath the nucleus, as prolapsing the entire nucleus would sometimes cause zonular dialysis. Cortical aspiration and irrigating the bag to remove the cortical remnants is done with extreme care. The intraocular lens is then placed in the bag under a coarser viscoelastic device with the haptics of the IOL directed in the coloboma area. The anterior chamber is then filled with balanced solution, the side port irrigated after intracameral moxifloxacin, and the conjunctiva is sealed. This video has been presented due to the lack of literature demonstrating the safety of small incision cataract surgery in hypermature cataract with coloboma. The combination of coloboma and white cataracts can be challenging, and this video demonstrates that a small incision cataract surgery can be a safer alternative to phacoemulsification in these cases. This video could be helpful to all postgraduates and practicing ophthalmologists. Thank you.